especially as an actor, there's way too much to do. So I think that there was no time to be on your phone. You live in a very vast world with people with a lot of opinions. I'm very open to constructive criticism. I gave it my all to eventually give it to an audience. What your co-actor gives you is what helps you bring out your performance also. How me as the actor and Sandhya as the director interpreted the character. I don't think that I let it affect me as much because you have to sift through it. All of us, I think, to some degree. Yeah. But Sonakshi was very calm, even Aditi was. He also made Priyanka Chopra dance with a flag in Bajirao Mastani. Priyanka Chopra has done it amazingly, amazingly. Like, I don't think I'd ever be able to live up to that, but yeah, Kashi.
I am Gayatri Nirmal, and today at Pinkula we have the Heera Mandi fame, R. Alam Zeb or Shaman Sehgal. Welcome to Pinkula,
Thank
Shaman.
You.
Okay. Let me start with Heera Mandi. Because the show is such an intense one, so we'll start with an intense question, which is, if you had to write a letter to Alam Zeb now, today, what would you write and why?
Okay. So this is, it's a very nice thought. It's basically my letter would be about how there is a light at the end of every tunnel. Because even Alam Zeb's character, if you look at it, she keeps learning through her experiences. She keeps getting like put down and then she comes back up and then she gets put down again and then she learns throughout her experiences. So you have to get through the tunnel to see the light at the end of it. So I think that's what my letter would be about.
That's a sweet one.
Dear Alam Zeb, there's a light at the end of every tunnel.
Yes. The show is, it's been quite a while that the show streamed online. Still, there is immense chatter on social media about it, which is very rare for any series to do. I mean, so what do you think has really worked for this show, Heera Mandi, that people are still talking about it?
I think with Heera Mandi, the characters are so dynamic. So they're very interesting characters to watch. So people want to understand their motives, their motivations to do what, why the character is behaving the way they behave. And at the end of the day, it comes down to what I would like to call the Bhansali verse, which is where he transports you into his world. Okay. Heera Mandi, it's nothing like you've ever seen before. Like he creates a environment, he creates an atmosphere, he creates a world where you feel like you're no longer in normal life.
It's another world.
So I think that's kind of what an audience's main attraction would be.
So while there's a lot of love that has been coming Heera Mandi's way, however, there's a certain section of cinephile that have not liked your performance. What would you like to say about that?
I mean, at the end of the day, everyone is entitled, every audience member is entitled to their opinion. Creators, every creative person creates for an audience. And they are a very important part of a creator's journey and a creator's life because it also helps you grow and evolve. And it's all, with negativity comes positivity, with positivity comes negativity. And at the end of the day, you have to take it all in and then figure it out accordingly and what resonates with you and what doesn't resonate with you. So I'm very open to constructive criticism but I played Alam Zeb's character the way me and Sandhya interpreted Alam Zeb's character. She is quiet, she is like nuanced, she is innocent, she is vulnerable to that degree. And I think it stands out a little differently is because she's not a tawaif. So that I think is an important part of the character and how me as the actor and Sandhya as the director interpreted the character. And I did put in a lot of hard work and at the end of the day I gave it my all. But I gave it my all to eventually give it to an audience. And they do have the right to say what, to voice their opinions. And in the world we live in today, it's very easy and like accessible to be able to voice your opinions.
That's right. But at the same time, Shaman, along with being an actor, you are also a human being. So as a human being, these comments do affect you, have certain sort of impact on your life. And so how do you deal with it? How have you been dealing with it? Because it could put you in a very dark side to an extent where it could affect your mental health as well. So how did you deal with everything?
I mean, I've been working on my mental health for a very long time in my life now. It's not just throughout my acting life. It's something that, like, when you start understanding yourself better, it becomes a lot easier to realize that you live in a very vast world with people with a lot of opinions. And I've chosen this profession to cater to an audience. So I was prepared for reactions and responses. And there's been so much love also. Sometimes looking at the negativity, we tend to completely omit the positivity. And that is something that maybe the first few days it did, like, I just felt a little like uneasy. But after that, it's always a constant dialogue with yourself, right? You have thoughts and then you think about those thoughts and you judge, that's what shapes morality and ethics as, like, so basically you keep having that inner dialogue with yourself and then you pull yourself out of whatever, even if you're down. But I don't think that I let it affect me as much, because you have to sift through it, because there are people that are saying positive things also, and I can't negate that fully, because those people have taken their time out to write good things about me, and I cannot sit and fixate on somebody that's taken their time out to write negative things about me. If it's constructive, then yes, I'm very open to listening to it, but if it's not, then you have to focus on the amount of love that I'm getting. My DMs are filled with a lot of love. Like, negativity tends to be spoken about a lot more in public because people want to talk about negative things. But there is a lot of positivity also, and, like, need to embrace that as well.
Talking about Sanjay sir, he is a genius filmmaker, we all know. And when was it that you witnessed the geniusness of him as a filmmaker? Something that you witnessed on the sets of Bajirao Mastani.
There was this one day where we all went to set, and it was the scene in Bajirao Mastani where Priyanka Chopra is removing Ranveer Singh's armor after he comes back from the war. It's in the beginning of the movie. Yeah. And we got ready 3 hours, everyone took to get ready, came to set. And they were doing the scene, and then I don't know what happened. I was also an assistant, so I wasn't there the entire time. But we just kept rehearsing the scene for the full day. We packed up, only rehearsing the scene. And the next day he came and I don't know what he did. He just got inspired, and then the whole scene just changed. And it was just so, that scene came out really nicely, because you see Kashi and Bajirao's equation and the love that they share. And I was like, okay, he takes his time and he sees things the way other people don't see them.
Absolutely.
And it's like, he also on Heera Mandi, the stuff he's made people do, pretty mind blowing. And he also made Priyanka Chopra dance with a flag in Bajirao Mastani. So as an assistant, I think I understood Sanjay sir quite a bit. And also watching how he pulls out small, small nuances, and he'll change small things, but it'll make a huge difference.
Yeah.
So overall, I think I keep understanding how much of a genius he is every day. So
because you firsthand witnessed all this, looking at his filmography, did you ever feel like, oh, this is one female character by Sanjay sir that I wish I could have done one someday?
Kashi.
Kashi.
Because she's very vulnerable. She's very vulnerable. But I don't think Priyanka Chopra has done it amazingly. Amazingly. Like, I don't think I'd ever be able to live up to that. But yeah, Kashi.
Yes. Sweet. And also there is this thing that since he's your uncle, so was there a moment where you thought that maybe he's turned a little softer towards you on the set? Or was he the same like how he is with all the other actors?
No, I don't think he had any reason to turn soft towards me. Because at the end of the day, he loves his work and I love my work also. So I wouldn't want him to be, and he wasn't going to be. So we are in a professional environment at the end of the day. So work is work.
Work is work.
And right. It's a lot, it's a very big responsibility. He's Sanjay Leela Bhansali. So I want to do my best and to make him proud, and that would require me him to not be nicer to me than he is to everyone else, because it'll affect how he perceives me and my characters also. And he's very professional like that. He knows how to draw the boundaries.
Shaman, for you in Heera Mandi, which scene do you think was the toughest for you?
I think my first day of shoot, which was Ek Baar Dekh Lijiye. I reached set and suddenly I have to do all these like moves and like lie on the bed and my hair is half wet and not half wet. And then for the first time I was standing in front of the camera and Sanjay was behind the camera and like being directed by him and trying to execute his vision. I think I realized by the end of it that I was going to be a very different person when Heera Mandi came out. But yeah, that kind of detailing in a scene, I think that I was very nervous. Honestly, I was very nervous. Mm-hmm. And I think I took those nerves and then just channeled them into Alam Zeb's vulnerability and innocence.
Yes. So among all the co-actors that are there in this show, who would you spend the maximum time with on the set and what did you learn from them?
I think I spent the most amount of time with Manisha ma'am and Aditi. And I think from Manisha ma'am, I learned how to be, I mean, it sounds so generic when I say I learned from Manisha ma'am how to be an actor, but from what Manisha ma'am is and what Malika Jan is, they're poles apart. I mean, even Alam Zeb and Sharmin are very different, but what she has achieved with Malika Jan's character to tap into that headspace and still be Manisha Koirala and be Malika Jan at the same time, I think I picked up that how to play a character that's so different from who you are as a person and how to persevere. She pushed herself every day and like she worked very, very, very hard. Like it was very evident to see, and I'm very grateful that I get to be a part of her comeback. And it was, and Aditi, I think I learned how to be kind. She's very kind and very sweet. And she also very motherly. So yeah, so she was always very motherly towards me and very sweet. So I learned that from Aditi, and how to be graceful also, because Aditi is very graceful.
She is.
Yeah.
Her Gajkamini walk is also getting very viral.
Yeah.
So what's happening next for Sharmin? And
I don't know. Heera Mandi just got over. Like, it's still going on. Like you're saying, people are still talking about it. It's still going on. I'll take it as it comes.
So, there's this one actor that you would love to collaborate with in the future? We all have a wish list. So, you may have someone, you know, I want to work with this particular actor. And why?
Ooh.
I mean, do you have such a wish list?
I don't. Not any specific actor. But I do believe that it is like when what your co-actor gives you is what helps you bring out your performance also. But I don't have a specific wish list. I think for me, it's more about the character, the story, I can't just dictate someone else's casting. It's more about the story, the character, the director.
Yeah.
So those are the things that I'd look at ideally in terms of what my wish list would be.
Okay, so now we'll play this fun game, which is going to be about Heera Mandi.
Okay.
So, you have to tell me, who is this one person who would always be glued to their phones on the set?
Nobody.
Phones are not allowed?
No, nobody would. There's too much to do on a film, on a set, especially as an actor, there's way too much to do. So, I think there was no time to be on your phone.
Okay. Who was the masti khor amongst everyone?
Everyone's gonna say me only. But there were
lots. You can also take your own name.
Yeah, me. There'll be a lot of me's in this book. I've done these games before.
Okay. Biggest foodie?
Me.
You? What do you love to eat?
Pizza.
Pizza.
Pizza and cake.
Who would always wait for breaks during the scene?
Breaks?
No one.
Not during the shoot. No one. Because I think we wanted to also get the work done and like finish shooting. Because if we keep taking breaks, we're not going to finish the scene.
Right. Who would always be very worked up until their scene was shot or before going for the scene?
Would be worked up all of us, I think, to some degree. Yeah. But Sonakshi was very calm, even Aditi was. But I think when you're on in a high pressure environment, sometimes you do get worked up. Even I used to get worked up. But I think everyone was on the same page on that. I don't think anyone got like too worked up about anything. Nervousness, of course, but worked up, no.
Who was the most caring one on the set? Like, who would care about everyone? Did you eat? Did you...
Aditi.
Aditi, like you said, she's motherly.
Aditi. Yeah.
Who do you feel has a good fashion sense among everyone?
Fashion sense? Mm-hmm. Manisha ma'am. Yeah, Manisha ma'am dresses very coolly sometimes. I see her Instagram, like, damn, Manisha ma'am dresses very cool. Manisha.
Who is that one person who just couldn't stop themselves from looking into the mirror?
Me.
Me. A lot of me's.
Me and also, but actors, right? We tend to look in the mirror. All of us are looking in the mirror at the same time. Like, you see BTS photos, all of us would be standing with our mirrors.
Who is wittier?
Witty? Yeah. Sanjay sir.
Sanjay sir?
Very witty.
Okay. If you could steal one thing from the following actors, what would it be? Manisha Koirala.
Experience. And her dog. Okay. Mowgli Koirala.
Aditi Rao Hedri.
Work experience. And her cats.
You love pets.
I love pets. Yeah.
Sonakshi Sinha.
Her work experience. And her demeanor. It's very
calm. Yeah. Like you said. Okay, Sharmin, thank you so much for that. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you so much for talking to me. Really appreciate it. This was fun.
Thank you. Glad you liked it.
Hi, this is Sharmin Sehgal and you're watching me on Pink Villa.